It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is the 30th day of January 2023. It's 40 degrees out. And why are Peter and I testing a Titan Pro motor run capacitor? Why? Why are we testing this? Stick around, smash that thumbs up button. How you doing, Peter?
Pretty good.
I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
Friday last week, in case you don't know, he ran his first service call. We're very proud of him. And now with our next service call, let's go see what's going on. We're doing a tune-up on a gas-fired furnace and checking out the air conditioning.
All right.
A homeowner is 15 minutes away. We're here doing a tune-up and a general inspection of the two HVAC systems he has. If you notice, we'll do a visual inspection. We see the two disconnect panels right there, one marked first, one marked top. Well, we want to make note that the disconnect panel was not resecured. That's not a good thing. Just take a general overview of the condition of the condenser. We have a lot of corrosion. Keep in mind, the ocean is literally right there. That's the Atlantic Ocean. It's cold, right? We're in Auvergne by the sea. We got some firewood here that's decaying. Coil, and the one in the back. This one actually looks a little bit better. This one looks actually much better. Take a look, peek inside. So let's remove some debris to start. Get in there and disconnect our power. Take a look at our components. We're doing an assessment because he's considering replacing the equipment due to just preventatively. We got this 14 SEER equipment. Are we 410A? Let's see who we are. I can't see. Where is 410A? I can't see. Yeah, so we're 410A on both systems, so they're not that old. The one in the front here, she looks pretty bad. And the one in the front is top, and the first floor is the one closer to the house. Let's take a look at the other side of the coil, and yeah, she's also shot. Well, shitty, sorry. Let's pull our fuse disconnect. Wow, we don't see that often.
All right. Taking a look at the first electrical compartment. See how it looks like in there. We have a Titan HD. That must have been one that we put in here. Capacitor. Yeah, I guess we could test resistance across the two terminals. We could do that. A lot of some corrosion right there, as you notice. Let's get the voltmeter and pair of needle noses. We'll check out the capacitor. Again, just doing a quick visual inspection. This was replaced last season, so we know she's good, but we'll test it anyway. So while he's working at getting the voltmeter and the needle nose, I'm gonna disconnect, remove the panel.
Right, so I just removed the two wires, low voltage wires from both sides of the contact of the coil. And we're gonna put our voltmeter, multimeter, to read resistance. And we're gonna touch both sides of the terminals and see what we get. There we go, 28, 16. I like to see around 15, 20, so we're good. Contact is still good.
All right, next we're gonna get a Sharpie, and I'm gonna write yellow for yellow there, and this is brown. Okay, now we're gonna disconnect these wires. Before doing so, it's gonna just make sure they're all shorted out. Now, I know some of you guys, the AC guys, love to follow Ted Cook. He likes to use his fingers, wet them, and short out the capacitors. I'm not that adventurous, so it's kind of scary. I don't do that, but one of the best things to remember is that the terminal, and this is generally, the terminal with two connections is generally your fan. The one with three is generally your compressor, and the one with four is generally common. All right, and now we know this is a 45.5 Titan HD. So let's set our voltmeter to read capacitance right there. So let's go from C to HERM, which stands for hermetically sealed compressor. Right there, perfect. Into there, good. And we're gonna get 40 on the dot. Look at that. Now go from C to fan, and we should get 5 and 5.1. Perfect, look at that. We're gonna carefully put our wires back on. And there is a way of dynamically testing this, and I'll put a link in the description box down below. I like to use the HVAC Tech School app. Let me show you what that looks like.
Yes, it was offloaded. There it is. Check this out. We have these cool calculators in here. Let's go to tools. We have under load capacitor test. So you type in your values, and there's a little chart here you can follow. Type in the values, and it tells you if it's good or bad. It's pretty cool. HVAC Test School for techs by techs. Give them a huge shout out, guys. Check them out. You can download in the Google Play and also in the
app. So one of the things we're going to do before we just finish up with this, we're going to plug in our unit back in, which is right here. That was marked top, right? It goes top. So let's plug this in, right? Okay. And now I'm going to push in the contactor. Make sure our fan comes on, our compressor comes on. If we want, we can also test amperage right now. Now, not really a good idea because our indoor fan is unknown condition, right? But I just want to do this to make sure that we connected all our wires back properly on the contactor and the capacitor. So we did that, we're good. My suggestion, again, preventatively, they can replace this, but it's still in good operating form. Right, we are unable to check refrigerant because of the low ambient outdoor temperature, which is 40 degrees, and we're next to the ocean. Preventatively, I would replace this one before I replace this one, just preventatively, the salt in the air, or start them on a four time a year rinse schedule or maintenance, where we come here four times a year and hose it off with some water from inside out. Okay, speaking of inside out, let's real quick, we're going to disconnect the power one more time. We're going to take off the top cover and we're going to see what's going on inside.
All right, let's see. So overall, see the coil starting to flake apart. The factory installed filter dryer is starting some rust there as well. Not in terrible condition, but you can see the coil starting to flake away and pretty clean, kind of ish, on the outside. And we have some leakage on the fan bearings. You know, those, it's packed oil, you know, it's factory packed. And once they start leaking oil, you know, the condenser fan motor is on its way out. So, what is this little thing right here? Looks like some kind of whatever. Doesn't belong in there. But okay. High and low pressure switches. Compressor, of course. And we seal up. We got that rust, that bimetal eating up action going on, as you can see there. But all right, Peter. You can put it back
together. All right, we're on unit number two. This is a Titan Pro. This is also a 45. And I got my money on
not good.
I got my money on not good. So let's put a Sharpie. Well, actually, you know what? Put yellow there. Why? Okay. Take all the wires off. Because brown is always condenser fan motor. Okay. So the only thing we need to worry about is the yellow, which is marked. And always have the red and the purple left. So let's take off all those wires and we'll test the capacitor.
I got money on it's not good. Comment to Herm.
45.
Coming to Herm. Oh, come on, coming to Herm. Oh, 40.3. Okay. Comment the fan. Oh, I lost. Damn. We both thought, and I'm sure many of you watching also thought, that that capacitor was going to be bad, but sure enough. You know why? I think it tested 40 on the microfarads? Because it's 40 degrees out. All right. So Peter's going to put back together the other first floor unit. And then we're gonna head inside and take a look at the furnaces and maybe take a peek at the evaporator coils. But my recommendation, again, if you want my professional advice, preventatively, I would go with replacing this one. And then in maybe a couple more years from now, replace that one. We're coastal. These units typically see 5 to 7 years, if that. I have customers that are literally, let's see, maybe about another 500 feet closer to the ocean, and they last 3 years at tops. So the closer to proximity to the ocean, the salt in the air, the salt water, all that good nasty stuff is going to drastically decrease life expectancy on the equipment.
Got a Bradford White, power vented. A little concerned about that. But other than that, okay. Venting looks intact. No condensate trap, not needed. Because the evaporator is after the blower. We're going to take out that flame rod. She's a little dirty there, and we'll test the hot surface igniter, and then we'll check the blower. Okay, let's get the voltmeter and let's test the hot surface igniter. I'm just going to disconnect it. We're going to set it to ohms. And there's this right there, tip of it. Okay, all right. So let's check out our meter, set it for ohms, and let's see what kind of a resistance we're reading on the hot surface igniter. And we're at 50, and that's good. Good. Okay. We'll plug that back in. So right there. And next we're going to take out our flame sensor. I'm going to use a 1/4 inch little stubby and take out the flame sensor and clean that with some scratchy paper.
Okay. There that is. One-handedly. It don't look terribly dirty, but we're going to take some scratchy paper, not lose the screw. Boom. Okay. We'll put that right there. It looks like someone was kind enough to leave the manual for the transformer. They have a Honeywell HG311. That's for 3 zones. I think they're only using 2 here, though. With dampers and thermostats. Peter, grab the thing in your hand, right? And like, wrap it around the thing. There you go. Say, excellent. And we'll put that back.
Okay, we have the little jumper wire right there, the magnetic ones. Okay, holding down the door switch. Where's the switcheroo?
I'm drawing crazy here. Okay.
My switcheroo is in place. That's holding the door switch.
And if we get the test though, we can do a combustion analysis. Watch this thing fire up.
All right, there's our hot surface igniter glowing. Valve open, and we have ignition. Peter's now got the probe inserted into that fitting right there. Plug is removed, and we're testing for our exhaust gases, O2, CO, stack temperature, and of course, most efficiency. So this is considered a 90%+ because she's venting with PVC pipe. I'm not going to say we're going to get that, but we should get close to that. So right now we are in low stage. And our numbers look so far so good. All right, so Peter just moved the jumper from W1 to W2. Now we are in high stage. We have an increase of gas out of the gas valve. Taking a look at our numbers. And they did go up. Carefully watching the O2 numbers, our carbon monoxide did jump up. And if you scroll down a little bit, we'll see some other factors, right? Like CO2, and I believe we're between 8.5 and plus or minus 0.5, and we are at, go back down, CO2. We are at 7.68. of CO2, so I'm gonna double check some facts on them in the manual.
No, this one never had a combustion analysis. We're at the first floor system, and the results are the same, so I couldn't pull up the gas pressures in the manuals I could find online on Goodman's website and also multiple websites, but one common observation with the one upstairs, the one down here, missing required condensate neutralizers. Had a look in the piping. Looks like it's PVC. Looks like it's PVC, so eventually it goes to cast iron eventually somewhere, and it's eating for the last 10 years. And I bet you there's thousands of units in this development and they all have the same thing. Yep. Not no bueno. No bueno. That was easy.
Yeah.
I gave him some pricing for 16 and 17 SEER carry equipment. And then he was like, well, it's better. It's what, 19 SEER and above? And I was like, let's get you with a Bosch IDS 2.0. It'll work with the equipment. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
We're not going to have like that crazy blower inside, but we'll have a crazy condenser outside.
Quiet ones.
Quiet. And sold. Look at that. Doing it next week.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed today's video as much as I enjoy creating it for you. To show your appreciation, please hit that thumbs up button. And if you haven't done so already, please consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. That's it for now. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.